Yo, happy anniversary, lady. That's my album, that's my baby, that's my project, that's my house. Like, that's the one. Y'all seen interviews, you've heard the songs, you know what you know. The transition from Silk to I Had a Vision, we all know all of that. I'm trying to give y'all some new information about this. A fun fact, if you will. I went back to 2017 in my journal, or my real nigga diary, and I wrote about fear that people weren't gonna like this album because it's so different than Pink Polo. Like, two different worlds, different maturity. Like, I was a dude that used to climb on top of the speakers and do the whole let's go in and jump, where the twerk is at, ba da da, and now I'm wearing Silk. Like, I was like, yeah, ain't nobody gonna like this. Like, all the fans that I accumulated and all the supporters are not gonna rock with this. But I still wanted to put it out. Like, I wasn't scared to drop it. I was like, yo, I'm about to lose fans over this. But that's what, hey, so be it. And then the beautiful surprise was how many fans I gained and how many people all over the world were rocking with it. And the thing is, when women love music, when women choose somebody as their favorite artist or just someone in their playlist, everybody come right behind them like, yo, we rocking with them too. Queen Sings. I think it's beautiful because Queen Sings has so many arcs in the storyline. Like, in many interviews I've talked about, yo, I made it in February. Like, Black Panther was coming out. It was Black History Month. Like, I was feeling myself. And so that was the first arc of it. It was like, yo, all this great energy. And then fast forward some years, then it's being re-premiered on BET. And then it's a whole new group of fans, like, discover me, like, wow, what's this saxophone in the mic? And the mic and the saxophone, like, it's cool to me. And I love my version of being Jamaican. Because, you know, I like to add, like, a little parsley to my music, like, just Queen Tings. Not Queen Things, corporate person. Queen Tings. And I love that. Honestly, I love my version of culture, my perspective. You know, that's all this is. This is just me writing and creating in my perspective and people enjoying that. So it's cool. It really is cool. And this is just one piece of the story. Like, people, I was born in June. I'm a Gemini. So, like, whatever you think you know about me, you do not know. Trust me. So all this lady, Silk, all that, goodbye. Well, hello. Well, farewell. Well, see you soon. No, I'm just kidding. But, like, every album, man, is a different story. And I love that. Because a Pink Polo fan and a lady fan, like, if they look at each other, one of them is pop locking, the other one is slow going. And I think that's amazing. And so with the next project and the next project, you're gonna see different sides of me. And we're gonna unite all of us in one place. And I think Lady is a very necessary part of my journey. And I can't wait to show you all more. Because by no means am I gonna make the same album twice. So enjoy this one. Because we have more movies to create sonically. And for now, happy anniversary, lady.
My name is Busiso. I'm from South Africa.
I am Chiara. I'm from Italy.
Josiah at Syracuse University.
My name is Shana out of Atlanta.
Speaking to Sihe from South Africa.
Just want to say thank you from London.
But it's Lerato here all the way from South Africa.
I'm shouting at you from Leicester in the UK.
So much love from this side. Love from Ghana.
My name is Jamela Gray from Paterson, New Jersey.
Buffalo, New York. I want to hear that saxophone, okay? Play me that saxophone.
Hi, my name is Azga. I'm from Kurdistan, Iraq.
Dad, I'm from Russia, and there's a lot of people we love to say.
Don't forget Brazil. We need you here. We want you here very much.
Lady to me is such a beautiful masterpiece.
This whole album, you know, it's like, It's all about women.
Lady is grown and sexy. It's passionate yet peaceful.
The right amount of soul, funk, R&B. beat and whatever song comes on, it just instantly puts me in a great mood.
I just love the vibes, man. Big up.
Lady Lady is classic. Lady Lady is timeless.
It's sexy. It's cool. It's beautiful.
It speaks to me. It speaks to the song.
And there are things that I wouldn't have realized about myself without Lady Lady.
Lady Lady feels like a love letter to Black women.
It's the mellow brushstrokes on the skies during an African sunset.
It is inspiring. It inspired me to write music again.
Lady Lady made me as a woman feel important, empowered, loved, beautiful, sexy.
Thank you for a great album. Thank you for just keeping it. I'll be always listening from here down under.